Let's take a tour of the ultimate storm-chasing vehicle, the Titus.
Well, one of the interesting things we have in our film is this custom-built storm-chasing vehicle called the Titus, and it's a character in and of itself, and that's based on these real tornado-chasing vehicles.
After years and years of trial and error, the Dominator 3, our newest armored vehicle, is the ultimate storm-chasing machine. It's like a cross between the Batmobile and a tank.
Titus was a fun one to do. When we talked about how to go about designing it, we just basically took what's required for the vehicle to function in real life, and we wanted to come up with something where the form did follow the function.
As real-life storm chasers, the whole reason we built the vehicles is to get into tornadoes and measure the wind speeds inside of the strongest tornadoes. And we've had this thing in EF4 tornadoes. We measured wind speeds near 200 miles an hour. And if I'm going to be in any vehicle, actually any shelter inside a tornado, I'd want to be in the Dominator 3.
So we got a lot of inspiration from real storm chasing vehicles, and we wound up having it built at a company called Custom Creations here in Detroit. And they did overall a phenomenal job.
So it looked fantastic, but unfortunately, it had some problems with it.
Well, it leaked. Yeah, it leaked. It leaked pretty bad on the first day.
The first day of photography, Matt Walsh was in the Titus. Yeah, I tell him, turn the water on, everything's going. And next thing I know, Matt's supposed to say a line, and he's like, we've got a breach.
It was like you were on the underneath decks of the Titanic. It was just, you're trapped, buckled in, and there was so much water coming. It's like, I don't think we can use this.
So it was to the point where Todd Garner said, I want you to paint a tiny little shark on the back of it. This is our Bruce, like in Jaws.
But I learned later on that the storm chasing vehicle from the storm chasing show, he was interviewed and asked if it was weather tight, and he said, no, it leaked like crazy. So we were right there with that.
And we have a backup Titus, which it's pretty good, but she leaks as well.
And actually, some of the crew lovingly referred to them as Hepatitis A and Hepatitis B.
It's actually the debris inside a tornado that's more dangerous than even the raw wind speed, because you add that much more momentum when there are things flying through the air, and it can be very dangerous. So the exterior of the Dominator is 16-gauge steel with a polyethylene Kevlar composite spray on the outside. And we tested it by shooting 2x4s at the Dominator. And with that extra coating on the outside, it prevents projectiles from going into the cabin. It also has an aerodynamic outer shell, so no wind can get underneath and lift us. And we added hydraulic spikes that will drill into the ground 8 inches and fasten us to the ground and prevent us from sliding. So we get in the path of the tornado, drop it flush to the ground like this, and let the tornado move over us.
Hey, let's drop down! Stop!
We're inside!
And the Dominator 3 has actual true bulletproof windows. So you press a button right where the tornado is about to hit, and then these protective windows pop up. Even if you had a shoulder-mounted grenade launcher, it wouldn't penetrate the windows. It might cause other problems.
So Titus needed to at least look like it could withstand 200-mile-per-hour winds, which made it a very broad, low-slung, sloping vehicle.
When Titus first arrived on the set, you know, the whole crew was completely blown away and excited. The production design was incredible. It is armor plated. It looks exactly like what you would think the state-of-the-art tornado chasing vehicle would be.
It's about 12,000 pounds, half-inch steel plating, so there's nothing really going to get through it.
Had to have a turret on top, not unlike a turret on a tank, but this one's for photography purposes.
Which gives us a 360-degree view of outside.
Because Pete's goal is to be right in line with a tornado and be able to get a shot looking inside the funnel of a tornado.
We had these wheels custom made by KMT. It's really a custom look.
And the mini weather system gives us all our data in the Titus itself. And the glass is bulletproof, essentially.
Oh my God!
Well, what makes her really special are these grappling claws.
These are the outriggers, giant claws. They come out, then they extend, then spikes go down into the ground and anchor it.
We're not going anywhere with those suckers dug in.
But in the end, it held up great. It could probably run for 100,000 miles the way Custom Creations built it. the Titus is shot as much from the inside as it is from the outside. So our set decorator, Brana Rosenfeld, met with one of the premier storm chasing scientists who gave her all the information on what kind of gear would be in there. And so we tried to follow that as closely as possible.
We find our tornadoes using all the information available to us.
Yes, there's a large tornado that with large debris, producing debris, destructive tornado right now, closing in on I-35.
So the Dominator 3 is decked out with state-of-the-art instruments, because if you're intercepting a tornado and you can't attach a number to those wind speeds, it's not worth it. We have our laptop going in the upper right, and that has the GPS data so we can navigate all the farm roads. It also has the real-time radar data we're tracking the storm so we can pinpoint the mesocyclones of the supercells. And that also makes it possible to storm chase at night because you don't want to depend just on lightning to see where a tornado is at night, but you need to be able to track it with our computers and see where the rotation is relative to our position in the storm. And on the roof of the Dominator, there's going to be a radar dome, and that's designed to scan the wind speeds inside the tornado right near the ground. We're also going to have a swivel air cannon, and that will shoot probes inside the tornado, and a parachute will deploy. They're carried around inside, and it's also decked out with cameras as well, because the visual part of science definitely can never be overlooked, and that's the fun part, is capture the video. And so Weather Service forecasters can see what storm chasers are seeing in real time in the field. And you continuously relay that information to Weather Service forecasters and media so they can deliver it to the people in the path of the storms.
So I thought it was important to show the science, and I wanted the interior shots to look right and be believable.
Mostly it's an observational vehicle, so it was all about the cameras and the hardware for that.
It's equipped with 24 surveillance cameras, so we have eyes from every angle.
And then when it came to the interior, my job was much more about how are the actors going to keep busy in there. Some of it's very practical. It's about having a button for the outriggers to move.
There's various monitors around the Titus that shows the graphics. There's like a quad monitor in the front that you'll see that has like four different images on one of the monitors.
Once we actually got the vehicle, we had a very short amount of time. It took about a week to get everything in and working.
And so I was very impressed with the teams that created Titus. It's just, it's a beast. It looks amazing, and they did a fantastic job.
I think it's impossible to build a vehicle that's truly tornado-proof. Even the Dominator, when it's dropped flush to the ground or the spikes deployed, if it's a strong enough tornado, will still go airborne. And I've seen semi-trucks fly through the air, radio towers. I've seen high-tension power lines pulled out of the ground by a tornado. And when you see that happening, even if we're in the Dominator 3, you know, we'll pump the brake a little bit.
This is the culmination of my life's work.
That means cut, Jacob. Cut it.